Hi friends, before going to start my session, I wanted to tell that if you are a teacher on that time, share this video with your students. If you are a student on that time, share with your friends. It is more helpful to them. Now I wanted to say that if you wanted the explanation in other languages, you can tell in the comment box. Now let's begin history class 10th chapter 8, Indian freedom struggle. This chapter we have completed till Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Now let's see Jawaharlal Nehru. Nehru entered the freedom struggle through the home rule agitation. He was a prominent leader into the non-cooperation movement of 1920 and was the president of Lahore Convention in 1929. First, we see that Nehru was entered to the freedom struggle through the Home Rule movement and he was the prominent leader of non-cooperation movement in 1920 and he was the president of Lahore Convention in 1929. The objectives of Purna Swaraj, a total freedom India, was declared during this convention. When Gandhiji withdrew the non-cooperation movement, Nehru got disappointed. Their aim was to bring the Purna Swaraj in our India. It means a complete freedom to our India, the totally free India. It was declared during the convention and the Gandhiji withdrew the non-cooperation movement. Through this task of Gandhiji, Nehru became disappointed. Nehru's idea gives a new direction to the political activity and he was influenced by the communist ideology. As a result, the communist learning became strong in the India and Indian National Congress, and consequently Nehru and Subhash Chandra Bose established the Congress Socialist Party. In nowadays also we see that the Nehru was the ideal personality related to the political activities. On that time also Nehru has been given the ideas related to the new direction to the political activities and he was influenced by the communist ideologies. As a result, the communist learning became strong and Indian National Congress is consequently Nehru and Subhash Chandra Bose have been established the National Socialist Party. Nehru was the president of 49th Convention of Indian National Congress. He declared that the Congress should stay away from the imperialist war and being fought at the international level. And he argued that the Charaka and Harijan movement were not very effective at that session and appeared to move away from the Gandhiji's ideology. When we see that Nehru was the president of 49th convention, in that convention we see that they were declared the Congress should stay away from the imperialist war, and that war was fought in between the international level, and he was argued in Charaka and Harijan movement. Those movement was not very effectively work at this session, and they were appear to move away from the Gandhiji's ideologies. At the 50th convention of Indian National Congress, Nehru adopted the soft approach towards his socialist and communist ideas. He declared today's Congress support complete democracy, democratic India, and it will be fought for the democracy, not for the socialism. In the 50th convention, we see that the Indian National Congress would be totally supported to the democracy, not for the socialism. He has given this statement, and we see that Prime Minister Nehru Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru was the architect of the industrialization and modern India. Jawaharlal Nehru and his Home Minister Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, who was properly known as the Iron Man, successfully brought together all the princely states and merged them with the Union of India. we see that the Jawaharlal Nehru had became the Prime Minister of our India, and that time he has given more importance to the industrialization and modern India. And the Jawaharlal Nehru and his Home Minister called Sardar Vallabhai Patel was. His Home Minister Sardar Vallabhai Patel, he was popularly known as the Iron Man of India, and they were took all princely state to state merge in all princely state merge the merge with the Union of our India. Later Nehru lead the foundation of Indian democracy he by reorganizing all the states on the basis of their language, a mixed economic system, system which had the principles of both capitalism and socialism, and his contribution to the modern India. He believed that the growth was possible through the intense industrialization, and he was the pioneer of the development of India through the 5-year plan. He was the founder of a 5-year plan in our India, with regard to the foreign policy, India and abundant that the polemic stand of two group and advocated non-alignment policy on the basis of Panchashil principles and in the country away from the power politics and aims at implementing that formula of the peace and harmony, and he was died in the year 1964. When he was became Prime Minister, on that time he has given more important to the industrialization and modernization, modern India. On that time the Home Minister of India was Sardar Vallabhai Patel. He has also been called as Iron Man of our India, and they were brought all princely state and merged as a Union of our India. Later they were moved towards the democracy and implementing democracy in our India. After that they has given importance to the mixed economy in the area of our India and capitalism, socialism, and the contribution to the modern India. He was also established the 5-year plan. After that the foreign policy, and he was appointed that the polemic stand of two groups in and advocated non-alignment on the basis of Panchashil principles, and they would away from the politics, power of the politics, and implementing the formula of peace and harmony, and he was died in the year 1964. Those are all about Jawaharlal Nehru. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you are all like this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe our channel.